गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
लास्ट डे आई डिस्कस्ड डैम्प वाइब्रेशन, द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ डैम्प वाइब्रेशन इन एलसीएस सर्किट, इज इट?
यस मैम।
सो सिस्टम मास, तो दैट इज एनालॉगस टू डैश इन एलसीएस सर्किट। एनालॉगस टू विच? मास एम इज एनालॉगस टू विच इन एलसीएस सर्किट?
L
L, that means
inductance.
Okay. So before starting of damped vibration in LCS circuit, you have to remember the differential equation for damped vibration for the mechanical system. Compare and you have to discuss all the cases. That means heavy damping case. Actually, this class was your electrical EE101. So, sir is absent today. So, in that place, I am taking this class. Forty-one students up to till present. So I'm just waiting 2 minutes more. Sharma, why are you coming late? And when I will give internal marks, you will get the effect of this. Everyone, you are thinking that you can come anytime. Now Anish Awad and Shubham Kumar,
yes ma'am,
both of you are coming late.
No ma'am, I was
in this way. Then I am What I was?
Joining through the.
Shubham Kumar Chaudhary, what I was?
Ma'am, I was joining through the 11th o'clock link. Ma'am, I didn't saw the before link. Now I came, ma'am. I was trying from 1-2, ma'am. 10-2, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am, for the.
Two links, separate links were given and it was posted yesterday.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Anyone late class, then I will note down the roll numbers. Time of giving internal marks, I will note down also your roll numbers. What marks I will give you. So be cautious about that. Because you are all wasting your time who are coming late. Now it is 10 minutes over my class. And just I am waiting for you all. So this is the last warning for you all. For your class. Two again absent, two students. Only 44, two are absent. Roll number one. Roll number one.
Yes, ma'am.
You.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number two.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Four.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number four.
Present, ma'am.
Five. Six.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number six. Roll number two.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Roll number three.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number three.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number four.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number four.
Present, ma'am.
Five.
Ma'am, five present.
Roll number five.
Ma'am, five present.
Roll number six.
Present, ma'am.
Seven. Roll number seven. Eight. Roll number eight. Roll number eight absent. Roll number nine.
Present, ma'am.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18. 19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
20. Roll number 20. 20 is absent. 21. 21, 22,
present, ma'am.
23,
present, ma'am.
23,
present, ma'am.
24,
present, ma'am. 25,
present, ma'am. 26, 27, 28,
present, ma'am.
29,
present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present ma'am.
37? Roll number 37?
Present ma'am.
38?
Present ma'am.
39?
38 present ma'am.
Present.
39?
Present ma'am.
40?
Present ma'am. Present ma'am.
41? Roll number 41?
Yes ma'am.
42?
Yes ma'am.
43? 44?
Yes ma'am.
45?
Present ma'am. Ma'am, 48.
Okay. So two roll numbers are absent, roll number 8 and roll number 20. Okay? Roll number 8 and roll number 20. For this class. Possible topic in LCR circuit?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Discussed last day that damped vibration. So resistance, inductance and capacitance. This is the circuit, this is key. Now when R equal to 0 in this circuit, if I put R equal to 0, then what ends? What the circuit? L and C circuit. If R is 0, it becomes LC circuit. And if R equal to 0, the oscillating circuit is undamped with angular frequency omega 0 equal to root. So angular frequency is equal to root over 1 by LC. So this is the frequency of undamped motion. And undamped motion is what? LC, that is LC circuit, not LCR circuit. Now, so this is the natural frequency actually, that is when there is no damping. Here that we know cases that I discussed, voltage across the capacitor is V equal to Q by C, plus the inductance equal to L into di by dt. Potential difference A, that is equal to across R equal to I into R. Now there are different analogous things that Here the resistance plays the part of a resistive or dissipative force analogous to that of friction, and viscosity is analogous to viscosity and friction in mechanical oscillation. Now here on pressing the key, the capacitor is charged, and when the key is released, the battery is thrown out of the circuit and capacitor starts discharging through the resistance. Since there is no external EMF as the battery is out of the circuit, then from Kirchhoff's law, we can write it as, this is, that is L into di by dt plus IR plus Q by C, that equal to zero. Explain all these terms. What is L di by dt? EMF across the inductance, voltage across capacitor V equal to Q by C, and potential difference across R equal to I into R. So these are the things, and from Kirchhoff's law we can write L di by dt plus IR plus Q by C equal to zero. Now that L in place of I have written d2 Q by dt square. In place of I have written dq by dt, then di by dt is d2q by dt square. These things I have already discussed, but I will discuss the three different cases as I have discussed in mechanical oscillation. So for that reason I'm just repeating. Then I into R, I means dq by dt, so R as it is. Then q by c, it remains as this. Now simplifying, d2q by dt square plus r by l into dq by dt plus q by c equal to zero, putting it equation number one. So our differential equation for damped vibration, that is d2x by dt square plus a by m x plus b by m dx by. From here if we compare, now here it is d2q by dt square, now here it is d2x by dt square. Two is analogous to x. Now r by l dq by dt equal is analogous to what? So q is analogous to x and r is analogous to b, and l is analogous to m. And a by m into x, so q is analogous, and a by m, that I'm just writing it as 1 by lc. M is analogous to L. So these are different analogous things that we have written. X analogous to Q, mass analogous to inductance, and B is analogous to distance. Now our general solution in damped vibration, it was X equal to e to the power minus kt, then A into e to the power root over minus omega square t, plus B into e to root over k square minus omega square into t. Now, as x is analogous to q, so in place of x, I have written q. So, q this. Now, here r by l equal to 2k, that I have written r by l. So, come to equation number 1 and then equation number 2. So, dq by dt is here. Here it is dx by dt. So, 2k I can write r by l. And omega square x, what is this? Omega square x equal to q by lc. So qx, so omega square equal to 1 by lc, that I have written. Omega square equal to, so omega square, it is given as this. Omega square, it is not omega square actually, this is omega equal to 1 by root over lc. So for large damping, now I am discussing three different cases. Now from where I am getting, that is omega equal to 1 by root over lc, omega equal to 1 by root over lc, that I am getting from here. Q by lc equal to omega square x, as it is analogous terms. So q is analogous to x, so omega square equal to 1 by lc. Omega square equal to, no root over sign is here, it is omega square equal to 1 by lc. Probably I have given these notes, and in that note PDF it is corrected. Is it the term corrected? Have you noticed this thing?
Yes, ma'am, it is correct.
Yes, ma'am.
I have corrected this, but in this PPT I have probably, this is some another file. So in the PPT, that is the PDF is given for you, the PDF of the PPT. there it is written omega equal to 1 by root over LC. Now three different cases arises. Now for large damping case or heavy damping case, K was greater than omega. Now what is K here? What is K?
R by 2L.
R by 2L. Okay, so in place of K, I have written R by 12, and what is omega?
1 by root over LC.
1 by root over LC. So R by 12 is greater than 1 by root over LC. And here, root over K square minus omega square, that is real. This is real term. So this is the case of large damping. So remember this one, because if it is given MCQ, I don't know what type of examination you have in semester, in the end of the semester. So remember this one, for LCR circuit, you are not getting actually K and omega, you are getting R by 12, you are getting R, L and C, LCR circuit, so A, R, L and C. So you have to replace K and omega in terms of this. So you just remember, if it is given for large damping case in LCR circuit, which expression is true? So different type expressions are given. So you have to remember R by 12 equal greater than 1 by root over LC. So I will say that if you have problem in remembering this, then only remember the differential equation of damped vibration for mechanical oscillation and the differential equation for LCR circuit. This is for LCR circuit and this is for mechanical oscillation. Now you just remember these two lines and only remember K is greater than omega for heavy damping, K equal to omega for critical damping, and here K less than omega for light damping. Only remember these cases. And what is K? If you remember these two differential equations, then why you can already find out, you can already find out what is K. 2K equal to R by 12, you know. K is greater than omega, so 2K equal to R by L. So K is what? So K here. So K is R by 12. So that you can calculate. Just you can, if you remember the differential equations, from there easily you can say what is the value of K. So my suggestion is that remember the differential equations. If you remember this, if you remember the this expression, that is R by 12 is greater than 1 by root over LC, then okay. In case, otherwise remember only K is greater than omega and put the value of K and omega. Now for large damping, the charge decreases gradually until the capacitor is discharged. The discharge is non-oscillatory or dead bit. Critical damping case. Now here K equal to omega. So what is K here? K is R by 12 and omega equal to 1 by. So from here you can calculate the value of R. R equal to what? R equal root over 1 by, root over L by C. For critical damping case, in this case, the discharge just become non-oscillatory and weakly. It is the limiting case between the deadbeat motion and the oscillatory motion. So you know that is for large damping case and critical damping case, both are non-oscillatory motion. And the conditions are K greater than omega and K equal to omega. And the according to that condition, according to the value of LCR, you can find out the. Now the last one remains, that what is small damping case? So small damping case, K is less than omega. So this is our condition. Now I have written the value, that is R by 12. And I have also written the value of omega, that is 1 by root over LC. L is less than 1 by root over LC. So from here, R is less than 2 into root over L by C. So this is the condition in for LCR circuit. So this is the small damping case. Now when the damping is less than the critical, the charge begins to oscillate and the electrical system exhibit damped harmonic oscillation. So only in the case K is less than omega, that means if r is less than 2 into root over l by c, then with this condition, the charge begins to oscillate and the electrical system exhibits damped harmonic oscillation. The charge of the capacitor repeatedly becomes positive and negative, eventually decaying to zero. So this is motion, so it is performing oscillation. The charge of the capacitor repeatedly becomes positive and negative, that it is as that is this is oscillating, ultimately going to zero. Now only in that case you are getting oscillation. Now you already know for mechanical oscillation x equal to c into e to the power minus kt sine of omega dot phi. So can anyone say into e to the power what amplitude. Is c?
Amplitude.
Amplitude.
The decreasing amplitude.
Students, just wait a minute. Am I audible? Students, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, place I have written to q0 e to the power minus 12 into t into sine of omega dash t plus phi. So this is your q e to the power minus r by 12 into t, that is sine of omega dash t plus phi. So what I have done, in place of c into e to the power minus kt, I have written q0, and in place of x, I have written q. Equation becomes, and here e to the power minus k into t. So e to the power minus k is what? Minus r by 12. So e to the power minus k equal to e to the power minus k equal to e to the power minus r by 12. So actually k, you know, for LCS circuit it is r by 2l. So k is r by 2l. So for this reason I have written the expression of q as q equal to q0 e to the power minus r by 12 into t into sine of omega dash t plus phi. Now already I discussed in mechanical oscillation that omega dash equal to omega square minus k square. Actually it was omega equal to k square. Here it actually omega is less than k. So for that reason, I have written like this. So omega dash equal to root over omega square minus k square. So what is omega dash here? Omega dash is, so I have written the value of omega square. Omega square I know, that is 1 by LC. And k square, that is r square by 4 L square. So only I have substituted the values of omega and k and it is written here. And what is omega zero? Actually, this is the natural frequency of undamped oscillation when R is zero. So this is undamped motion, and the natural frequency of undamped oscillation is root over 1 by LC. Now, this is omega dash I have. Now, actually, quality factor, I'm just defining letter in detail. What is quality factor? So quality factor here, Q equal to, actually, the formula is omega dash by 2K. So this is the formula of quality factor, that is omega dash by 2K. So 2K, I have written the value of 2K here. So omega dash divided by R by L. So ultimately, Q equal to L omega dash by R. So this is the quality factor. Just remember the expression of quality factor like this. After this, I will discuss what is quality factor. So quality factor Q equal to omega dash by 2K, that is omega dash by R by L. So it is L omega dash by R. Now, Q larger if R is smaller, that is small damping. Q has larger value if R is smaller, that is small damping case. So small damping case, that is when damping is small, when R is small. When no damping, what is the value of R?
Zero.
When zero. So zero. For high damping, for heavy damping or large damping, R will be very, R has very large value. Okay. And if R is smaller, then damping is also smaller. So when damping is small, then Q, that we can write it as L omega by R. Because then this is omega. Actually, quality factor is L omega dash by R. But when R is very small, that is small damping case, then Q becomes L omega by R. So here omega dash tends to omega. So for small damping case, omega dash tends to omega. So we can write it is L omega by R. So this is L omega by R. Now, why? Because from here you can calculate omega dash equal to this. Now, if R is very, very small, then square of this small quantity again is very small. So this term, minus term, is very, very small. This term, second term. So directly I can write that omega dash equal to 1 by root over LC. And again, we know that is 1 by root over LC. This is the value of omega 0. So in that case, frequency becomes the damped frequency. So that will be, this is, I have written Q equal to L omega by R. And this omega, if you have problem, then you can write this in place of omega 0. That is, this omega is just like omega 0. This is natural frequency. Is it clear what I am saying? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, quality factor is L omega dash by R. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
But if damping is very, very small, then omega dash becomes omega. Here, omega is what? Actually, the natural frequency. This is the natural frequency. If you have problem, then you, in this place, you can write omega zero. So omega dash and omega zero, they are same in that case. Why? Because omega dash has this expression. First part is the natural frequency and this is the damping term. So if R is very, very small, though a square of R square is also very small, so we can neglect this term, and then that omega dash only becomes 1 by root over LC. So that is what? That is natural frequency. So from there, we can write that L by R, I have written L by R, and in place of omega, I have written this thing. Let me check. Is it okay or something problem is here? Well, I have, it is typed material. So when I have typed, so you have to write the value of omega. Omega means 1 by root over LC. Okay. Is it okay? It is okay. So, not okay.
One.
So there is problem. Now I'm finding what is the problem in typing. So it is Q equal to L omega by R. So L by R is here. L by R is here. And what remains? Omega. Now, omega is what? 1 by root over LC. Okay. So this term, root over L by C, that will be what?
1 by root over LC.
So you will put it. Okay. When I will send it, correcting this one. I will send the note again, correcting this one. So Q equal to L by R into omega, and omega equal to 1 by root over LC. Okay. So that is the value of quality factor. So that means if I just eliminate this L, is it okay then?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is 1 by R into root over L by C.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So it will be in this expression, Q is 1 by R into root over L by C. Okay. So this L will be eliminated. If I put the value of omega equal to 1 by root over LC, then we will get the expression Q equal to 1 by R into root over L by C. Now for in general, what is our Q? I'm just, after this class, I will discuss what is quality factor in detail. So quality factor Q equal to, actually the formula is L omega dash by R. It is clear from here. L omega dash by R. And what is omega dash? Omega dash is what? Root over 1 by LC minus R square by 4 L square. Understand? So you will remember this expression of Q in general. That is quality factor equal to L omega dash by R. Quality factor is L omega dash by R, and the value of omega dash equal to root over 1 by LC minus R square by 4 L square. Now here, actually question is given, numerical problems are given. Find out the quality factor or find out the frequency of oscillation. The LC and R values are given and you have to find out. Now, if damping is small, then you can find out. If damping is very, very small, then you can only write the small damping cases. You can neglect this term and ultimately you can write this one. That's 1 by R into root over 1 by LC. So you will remember the general expression of Q, and depending on this, you can find out the quality factor of LCS circuit in damp vibration. Understand? Hello, students.
Yes, ma'am.
So
yes, ma'am.
You will hear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. For LCS circuit, what you will remember? For LCS circuit, you have to remember. For LCS circuit, you have to remember the expression of equation for LCS circuit. Then three different cases: heavy damping case, critical damping case, and large and small damping case. For heavy damping case and critical damping case, there are no oscillations, and only for small damping case you are getting oscillations. And the expression, this is important. If it is given, write down the expression of charge in case. So this is Q equal to Q0 e to the power minus R by 2L into T sine of omega dash T plus phi. So this is the expression of Q, and we have the expression of omega dash. The omega dash is like this. Omega 0 is this. This is the natural frequency when R is 0. So you can actually here in this case, I have written omega dash, omega equal to omega 0. Omega dash equal to this. If R equal to 0, then omega dash becomes 1 by root over LC, that is omega 0. So omega dash becomes omega 0 when R is 0. So here in this case, for here you can write L omega 0 by R. So if you are confused, you can just write it as L omega 0 by R. And that is the expression, that is 1 by R root over L by C. So remember this one. Your numerical problems are very important from this. It may be given. They find out the quality factor or find out the damp frequency. What is omega dash? Omega dash is the damp frequency. So what is the value? if you remember this value numerically, you can calculate. If you know L, R, and C, then you can find out omega 0 and you can also find out omega dash, and also you can find out quality factor. In my next class, say.
Ma'am, can you explain again?
Which one?
This omega dash and omega 0.
Omega 0 is what? Omega 0 is what?
Root over 1 by
LC. And what is that? When there is no damping, the frequency.
Ma'am.
Omega 0 is that when there is no damping in the circuit. Okay. Omega 0 is that frequency when there is no damping. Yes, ma'am. And when there is no damping, when the value of R is?
0.
When the value of R is 0, then zero. There is no damping. So simply from this, omega dash equal to this. This is the expression. Now when R equal to 0, then omega dash becomes root over 1 by LC. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
So omega dash equal to root over 1 by LC. When R equal to 0. And what is the value of root over 1 by LC?
Omega naught.
What is the value of root?
Omega 0.
Omega naught. So can I write omega dash equal to omega naught? So can I write omega dash equal to omega naught when R equal to 0?
Yes, ma'am.
So we can write omega dash equal to omega naught when R equal to 0. R equal to 0 means no damping. R equal to 0 means no damping. That means the circuit becomes LC circuit. R equal to 0 means undamped motion frequency. So in that case, omega dash becomes omega 0 when R equal to 0. And I have taken here, that is if R is very, very small also. When R is 0 or R is very, very small. R is very, very small means it is small damping case. So also in that case, omega dash is omega 0 b if R is very small. So square of a small quantity, again very, very small. So also we can neglect this term. So also in that condition, omega dash equal to omega 0. So for that reason, I have written here omega. So you will write better that it is L omega 0 by R. L omega 0 by R when R is small. Because if R equal to 0, simply omega dash equal to 1 by root over LC. But if R is very small, that is small damping case, if the value of R is very less, then also if we square it, R square, so minus of this. So if this term is very, very small, I want to say 1000 or 10 to the power 4 minus 0.001. What is the value? Can I neglect that 0.001?
Yes,
1000 से 0.001 subtract कर रहे हो, ठीक है? तो 0.001 इतना problem है, मानो तुम्हारे पास calculator नहीं है, हम तुम्हें पूछ रहे हैं, तो तुम क्या calculator से calculate करोगे और बोलोगे directly नहीं और उसके ऊपर root over है कुछ भी है, ठीक है? और बोलोगे ठीक है, इतना small है value, so this is very small value, so I will just neglect this one, so minus के बाद कोई भी बहुत small quantity it is there, so we can directly neglect that thing. So again omega dash equal to omega 0. So that I have written, if R is very, very small or if R is totally 0, then the Q value is like this. Otherwise omega dash you can calculate whatever value you will get putting the, if R is very small, okay, R may be very small, you are putting the value and you have the value of L, C and R, so you are putting in that expression and you are calculating the value. So you will get some omega dash value, some value you will get, and omega 0 you can also calculate 1 by LC. So you can find out the difference. You will find out if R is very, very small, that is omega dash and omega zero nearly equal, is it? So actually in numerical problem LCR values will be given. So if r is very small value is there for r, you can directly calculate the value of omega dash, that is damped frequency, angular frequency. You can find out this value, and also you can find out this value. Then you will conclude that these values are nearly equal as r is very very small. And otherwise, if r has large value, then you can find out this value from here, that is q equal to. So ultimately what you have to do, you have to remember this expression of q, you have to remember this expression of omega dash, and you have to remember the expression of omega zero, and also the quality factor is L omega dash by R. Remember this one, omega quality factor is L omega dash by R. If LCR values are given, from there you can directly calculate the value of omega dash following this equation, and whatever value you are getting, you will put it here, and that will be the value of quality factor. Then you have to take, if LCR values are given, directly put it, calculate and put it here and find out the value of quality factor. Understand? Is it okay now?
Yes.
Okay. So the time is almost over.
Yes, ma'am.
So the time is almost over. So come again, join again after 10 minutes. Okay? So I want to say two students are absent, roll number 8 and roll number 20. I have to send the absentee report to your HOD, to your HOD, that who the number of students absent for one day. Just I have to send for after every of my class. Be very very punctual at the time of joining and also attending the class. So today up to this, for this class and for my next class after 10 minutes, that I will discuss first what is quality factor, because I have not discussed in detail about the quality factor. So quality factor I will discuss, then I will go to the forced vibration. So this is the end of damped vibration. I have discussed different things for damped vibration, including LCR circuit. Now I will go to forced vibration. 11.
Ma'am, for this class we will give the attendance through Google form.
Yes. This so different class means different attendance. Okay. Today I have two classes, so you will get two. You will fill up your attendance just now, and after that class from 11, you will again fill up the attendance. So actually, I will start my class from 11:05. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, actually, after 10 minutes,
okay,
I will start my, and just fill up the attendance just now.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.